Let's go back to a simpler time. There's nothing quite like taking a stroll down memory lane and reliving the shows that we so much looked forward to back in the day. Today, let's revisit Little House on the Prairie. It was 1974 and America needed the Ingalls. The country was in the midst of a tiresome and controversial war in Vietnam, and a rustic cabin in the wilderness filled with a wholesome family was exactly what we needed. And although the show followed the life and adventures of a family living on a farm in the late 1800s, the issues they dealt with are still relatable to viewers even today. The show became a big hit right off the bat and will certainly be remembered as one of the greatest shows of all time. The show was based on the best-selling series The Little House books, which were actually semi-autobiographical, based on the author Laura Ingalls Wilder's real-life family. Laura lived from 1867 to 1957, and is responsible for creating the book series that would pave the way for several on-screen adaptations. I'm your little host today, Nostalgic Nick from Do You Remember, and we're looking back at the cast of Little House to see what they're up to now. Be sure to hit the like button in the bottom right-hand corner, and make sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button.
I've decided something.
What's that, Hepa?
Home is the nicest word there is.
Melissa Gilbert was perhaps the most famous child actor in the world during the show's live run. She played the role of Laura Ingalls on Little House on the Prairie and first got her start in the industry as a child actress in the 1960s. She remembers the audition process with Michael Landon, who was already hugely successful from his role of Little Joe Cartwright on Bonanza. Laura remembers walking into the audition and him having this unbelievable glow that was captivating. She told Entertainment Weekly, "It's trite to say, but he had me at hello. I wasn't even 9 years old yet." And it's easy to see why. But the relationship between Melissa and Michael Landon would parallel their predetermined on-screen one, as Michael became a real-life father figure off-screen for Melissa as well. Sadly, Melissa lost her biological father at age 11, so when not working on the Little House set, Gilbert spent most weekends visiting Landon's real-life family. Landon would share advice about how two things were important: home and family. Gilbert's career peaked in the 70s and 80s as she was featured in popular television movies such as The Diary of Anne Frank, Choices of the Heart, and had a major challenge of a role taking on Helen Keller in 1979's The Miracle Worker, in which she got to co-star along with Patty Duke, who won an Oscar for that same role in 1962. Melissa has starred in a few shorts, films, and TV shows over the last few years. She currently has one film in post-production set to
I've used up your quota for misbehaving for about a month.
She has also recently been promoting a new podcast with her husband, Timothy Busfield, and talks about her experience working on Little House on the Prairie in one of the episodes. Sounds like Little House has a very special place in her heart, and it's clear to see why. Michael Landon. Michael had a career on the small screen that ran into three decades, becoming a household name by starring in Crossroads, Telephone Time, and I Was a Teenage Werewolf. His career jump-started with a bang. Playing Little Joe in Bonanza truly established him as a big TV star. After starring in such huge hits, Landon felt like writing episodes and directing them. This opportunity was presented to him by Ed Friendly, the producer of Little House on the Prairie. Michael Landon joined the Prairie cast as Charles Ingalls, and this would become one of his most successful roles. If you watch Little House, you are truly watching Michael. He was not only the rock of the show acting-wise, he also directed the pilot episode. He set the tone. Much of the success of the series can be attributed to the relaxed and confident atmosphere on set. Michael made sure that people on the set understood that they were involved in something good, something wholesome. He had a distinct vision of how the show would resonate with its viewers, and he was right. His journey as a cultural icon continued even after Little House on the Prairie ended. Landon starred in the hit show Highway to Heaven as a probationary angel who named himself none other than Jonathan Smith. His co-star was Victor French, who he had previously co-starred along with on Little House on the Prairie. Unfortunately, Michael Landon died in 1991 from pancreatic cancer, but we owe much of the authenticity of Little House to Michael and his vision. Melissa Sue Anderson. Melissa Sue was cast as Mary Ingalls after just a few successful commercial spots. In the beginning, while her acting skills weren't really discovered by the writers of the show, she had quite a trying time in putting herself on the map. But once she did, there was no stopping her. She even had her first on-screen kiss on The Brady Bunch.
And I really appreciate it.
Wow. For her role as Mary Ingalls, Anderson received an Emmy nomination in 1978. That very same day, Melissa Sue graduated high school at age 15. Not a bad day, all things considered. I think all I got on graduation day was a lunch at Howard Johnson's. Hey, I'm not complaining. Melissa Sue even went ahead and worked as an associate producer on Michael Landon's final TV projects. She will turn 58 years old this coming September 2020 and is no longer very active in the industry. You can count on seeing her pop up every so often, especially in TV movies, her most recent being in 2018's The Con Is On. Karen Grassl. Karen Grassl played the matriarch of the Ingalls, Caroline Ingalls.
Now if I hear wolves at night, I won't be afraid.
Oh, we've heard them lots of times before. If you were afraid, I never knew it.
I was, but I won't be now.
One of the most versatile actors on the list, Grassl began acting at Berklee University and jumped at the chance to travel to London to further her arts education in 1965. And the education paid off. After returning to the States, she debuted on Broadway and earned a nomination for Best Newcomer. Though always loving the stage, it was time for the screen. She talks about the audition process, and once again, Michael Landon was very involved in the process. She described him getting right down on the floor with her to read the audition scenes. She says that Michael leapt to his feet and declared, "Send her to wardrobe." Ma really was the glue that held the family together. She exhibited a range of emotions on screen and went on to feature in shows that had very different roles. She was seen in The Love Boat, Murder, She Wrote, and Harry's War, roles she played that were totally different from her character Ma. After the show ended, she went on to pursue theater once again, and in 2009 also became the face of Premier Bathroom.
You, or someone you love, has a mobility issue.
And was last seen in 2017's Lasso. But Karen currently has a film in post-production called Not to Forget. And trust us, Karen, we won't forget. Lindsay and Sydney Greenbush. Twins, Lindsay and Sydney Greenbush shared the role of Carrie Ingalls. The Greenbush sisters were first seen on Little House on the Prairie at age 4. Lindsay has not actively appeared on screen much since her role in the TV series Butterfly in 1983. The only recent role she has is in a film called A Short Stop Away, which is currently in pre-production. Similarly, Sydney has not appeared in anything since the 1983 series Hambone and Hilly.
Hambone and Hilly, starring Lillian Gish, Candy Clark, O.J. Simpson.
We sure do miss them, though, on Little House on the Prairie. Allison Arngrim. Nellie and Laura may have fought in pretty much every episode of the show, but off-screen, Allison and Melissa's friendship blossom and are friends even still today.
Can you see it? See, get closer. Look out, Nellie! Look out! He'll break your jaw!
Allison played the role of Nellie on Little House and surely stood out among the cast. Allison told Closer Weekly that when the production moved from Paramount Studios to MGM in the late 1970s, they were ripping up the floor of the set, and what Melissa and I see lying beneath was the yellow brick road. Melissa and I went nuts. We were dancing all around, singing the song, pretending to be Dorothy. Post Little House, Arngrim continued working in TV shows and was an AIDS activist after her friend and on-screen husband, Steve Tracy, died from the horrific disease. Currently, she works as a stand-up comedian.
Really, I say these things I shouldn't say.
Her last acting credit was in a TV short called Living on a Prairie in 2017, and she currently has a rumored credit in the film Twice Upon a Song, set for a 2021 release. Richard Bull. Richard Bull was another actor who was already famous before starring in the infamous Little House on the Prairie. His role as the Doc in Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea secured his name as an amazing actor in the TV industry. And if you're wondering, yes, Richard Bull and Michael Landon's paths crossed on the set of Bonanza when Richard played a rancher caught in a vicious range war. We can't confirm if this meeting had anything to do with Bull getting cast, but considering how much control Landon had on the creation of the show, it's certainly plausible. After Little House on the Prairie, he appeared in Witless Protection and Boss. Sadly, he passed away in 2014 from pneumonia just months before his 90th birthday. We'll surely never forget him, especially as Nels Olsen, whose good judgment and sense of fairness helped make viewers feel better about themselves when watching the TV show. Did you remember these cast members from Little House on the Prairie? It's so hard to believe that it's been over 45 years since the show first aired. Make sure to like this video, and please subscribe to our channel so you won't miss a single video we come out with. And if you had one, let us know your favorite character in the comments below. From all of us here at Do You Remember, thank you for watching.